Good afternoon and welcome to the third session of the first round of the Cleveland International Piano Competition. I'm Jeroen Kohlberg, president of Piano Cleveland, and we're excited to bring to you five more incredible performances today. The performances were recorded in 10 locations worldwide, where the 26 contestants recorded close to their homes. So you will see that based on the safety regulations of the place, some of them will be wearing masks and others will not. Today, you'll hear performances by Vitaly Starikov, Anastasiya Magamedova, ZIYU Liu, Daria Parkhomenko, and Rafael Skorka. Our intermission feature will be presented by Stanislav Khristenko, our 2013 Mixon First Prize winner of the CIPC. This afternoon's performance is generously supported by Heister Yale Materials Handling. You are welcome to send your best wishes to your favorite contestant on our broadcast page. And you're also, as always, very welcome to donate directly to our contestant fund. This money will be supporting the contestants who do not make the semifinal round and is extremely meaningful for these artists. So we certainly hope that you will consider it. Thank you very much for joining us, and we're sure that you're going to enjoy the performances.
Hello, my name is Vitaly Starikov, and I am from Russia. Now, I live in Moscow, but my hometown is Ekaterinburg. It is a city in the middle of Russia. And there I started to play the piano when I was 6 years old. And I studied there until 18 years old, and after that I moved to Moscow, and I continued my study in world famous conservatoire in the Moscow Tchaikovsky conservatoire. And for the first round I've chosen works by Bach and Chopin, and not only because of they are ones of my favorite composers, but I mean that these composers have too many points of crossings of their styles of music, and I mean that composers are very close to each other. I hope that you will enjoy my performance. Thank you.
My name is Anastasiya Magamedova, and I'm originally from Dushanbe, Tajikistan. I now live in Paris, and I actually grew up in the United States. I moved to the state of Utah when I was 10. I began playing the piano at the age of 5, but I wanted to begin when I was 3. My parents didn't take me seriously. They thought it was just one of those things that I'll forget about in a few days. And so to prove them wrong, I found my first piano teacher myself by going up to random people in the park, to strangers, and asking them if they play an instrument. And that's how I stumbled upon my first piano teacher, who actually, to my disappointment, explained to my parents that I was too young to start at the age of 3 and that I had to wait until I was 5. So So I waited patiently for 2 years, and my parents thought I forgot. But for my 5th birthday, I really expected a piano, which I did not get from my parents. And when I brought it up to them, that's when they realized that I was serious, and I started lessons then. A piece I am very excited about in my first round is the Bach Toccata in C minor. And I always enjoy starting the program with Bach, and I hope that this piece is a nice start for you as well. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Stanislav Khristenko, and I'm the winner of 2013 Cleveland International Piano Competition. I'm very happy to be among the audience for the 2021 competition, and I'm very happy it's happening despite all the circumstances and all the difficulties that we all went through in 2020 and the beginning of this year. I have to say that Cleveland International Piano Competition was my last competition in my entire competition career, with over 50 competitions that I took part in between the age of 9 and 29. And I, of course, have a lot of wonderful memories, not just because it was the last competition that I took part in, but because of the whole range of different events, different things that happened to me after winning this competition, which kept happening many, many years after the competition in 2013. It included CD recording, Carnegie Hall recital, and lots of concerts around the United States, as well as Canada, Europe, and Asia. I went to perform after winning the competition, and the years of artistic management that I got as part of the prize brought me to these wonderful venues I performed in throughout the years. Unfortunately, this year the competition is happening in a little bit different format. Maybe unfortunately, maybe fortunately, because of course, being in Cleveland and meeting actually in person the community that surrounds the event, the entire 2 weeks, over 2 weeks event, people who come to listen, the people who follow from the Cleveland community, who support the competition, who really love classical music and help the event to happen. Unfortunately, many of the contestants this year are not able to meet them in person, but at the same time, the new format, of course, brings so many more people who can follow the competition, who can follow the performers, the performances, and the competition becomes a kind of a worldwide event. And I wish all the contestants to enjoy the opportunity to be heard by people who follow Cleveland competition for so many years, because the competition established really quite a name in the US and worldwide. And I wish everyone, whether you end up coming to Cleveland for the finals or you don't, to use this opportunity to really get pieces, works on the highest level possible, get those pieces performed in front of the of so many people worldwide, and really make it to the next stage in your performing career, whatever the result of the competition is. I also would like to thank the team who organizes the competition, who have been working throughout these years together. The team who organizes not just the competition, but also a concert series in Cleveland, different community events, educational events, and who really believes that classical music should be a major part of society in the Cleveland area. And I would like to thank them for such enjoyable time we had throughout these years. I'm very happy to listen to the contestants this year, and looking forward to see what the result is. But we all understand how subjective classical music and the arts is, and how different the results can be from one competition to another competition, from one group of jury members to another group of jury members. And I hope that those contestants who don't get a prize or don't get the first prize, which is the majority of the contestants, they keep remembering that this is just a step, a very major, an important step in their career and their path to making music and making people happy with what they're doing with on their instrument, and not to make one of the competitions one of the failures at the competition, really ruin their will and their love to music. I'm very much looking forward to hear the contestants, and I wish everyone, and I wish the audience worldwide, a wonderful time listening to the contestants, and I hope to see you again, and looking forward to meeting new winners of 2021 Cleveland International Piano Competition.
Hello, I'm ZIYU Liu. I'm from China, and now I'm living in Hanover, Germany. I started playing the piano at the age of 5, and I want to become a pianist because I love music, and music already become part of my life. So a piece in the first round program I'm very excited about is La Valse by Maurice Ravel, because this piece is such a virtuoso piece, both on musical and technical aspect. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Daria Parkhomenko and I'm from Russia. Currently, I'm living in Hamburg, Germany, and study at the Hochschule für Musik und Theater with Professor Stepan Simonyan. And in the same time, I'm a student at Fiesole Scuola di Musica in Italy and study there with Professor Eliso Versalazzo. I started playing piano at the age of 4 together with my sister. At that time, I liked very much to play together and enjoyed a lot. I won different competitions and played a lot of concerts, and the most things I liked about it was the preparation process, being on the stage and hearing the applause after a performance. I enjoyed playing this huge instrument. It was very interesting for me to present music to an audience, and this experience automatically entered my daily life and became for me the most important thing. A piece from my first round program I'm most excited about is Haydn's Sonata, because this is not a common sonata. It has an improvised first movement and very funny music in the final. I really like the switching of emotions in this piece, and hopefully you will enjoy it too. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Rafael Skorka. I'm 32 years old and I'm from Israel. I started playing the piano when I was about 8 years old, and growing up, music was a very big part of my life, although I had no idea it's going to become my profession. I also learned a bunch of other instruments. I played the clarinet for a few years, and before that the flute and even the mandolin. And my sister is also a musician. She also started with the piano, and after a few years she became a singer, and now she sings at the Israeli Opera in Tel Aviv. For my first round, the piece that I'm most excited about is the Haydn Sonata. Haydn, I think, is a composer who doesn't get the recognition he deserves, but his music is so inspiring and full of emotions and different colors and personalities. He can be the most serious composer, he can be the most humorous composer. Haydn basically allows the performer to just experiment with all sides of his or her personalities. And I think it's a very good piece to communicate with audiences. And that's why I'm really excited for you to hear my performance, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.